Hello friends, today we are going to have some basic introduction about transgenic plants. In the earlier video, we have seen how we can recover the protein product of a gene which we have already cloned in a bacterial host. In this video, let's see what else we can do with that particular gene. If we are not interested in purifying the protein product of the gene, what we can do, we can isolate the rDNA from the bacterial host cells, and then further we can isolate the gene of interest from the rDNA molecules using the specific set of enzymes, and then what we can do, we can transfer that gene into a plant in such a way that the gene becomes an integral part of the DNA of the plant and it gets distributed uniformly to each and every cell of the entire plant body. So two things are important. One is the gene should be integrated into the genome of the plant. And the second, the gene should be present in each and every cell of the plant body. If we are successful to do so, what we get a transgenic plant or a transgenic crop. Why it is called a transgenic plant? Because it has been produced by the insertion of a foreign gene. And that foreign gene, in scientific language, it is known as a transgene. So this plant has been created by insertion of a transgene in its DNA. That's why it is known as a transgenic plant. And if the plant which you are dealing with is a crop plant, then it is known as a transgenic crop. Moreover, this plant is also known as a genetically modified plant. Why? Because it has been produced by genetic modification of its DNA by introducing a foreign gene in it. That's why it can also be called as a genetically modified plant or a genetically modified crop accordingly. It is also called as a genetically engineered plant, and the reason behind this is same as before. So now the question is, why we need to produce the transgenic plants? There are three basic objectives of producing transgenic plants. The first one is to reduce the phenotypic effect of any undesirable gene present in the plant. Suppose there is a gene which is present in the DNA of the plant and whose effect is not desirable. Then what we can do, we can insert a foreign gene into that plant so as to reduce the phenotypic effect of the unwanted gene, so that we can improve the quality of that plant with respect to the human being. The second most important objective of producing transgenic plant is, if the plant is having some useful gene in its genome, but the phenotypic effect of that gene is not up to the mark, or it is not up to that degree which we want, what we can do, we can transfer a foreign gene into the genome of the plant so as to improve or facilitate the phenotypic effect of the concerned gene, so that the plant becomes more useful for the human being. The third important and the most important objective of producing the transgenic plant is, in some cases, what we want to confer an entirely new or novel character to the plant, which it never had before. For achieving the same, what we have to do, we have to insert the gene which is controlling the novel character which we want to transfer into the plant, we have to insert that gene controlling that new character into the genome of the plant so that the gene becomes the permanent part of the genome of the plant and the plant exhibits the novel character. So these are the important objectives behind producing transgenic plants. So the question is how we can produce such kind of transgenic plants. So to understand the basic scheme or strategy behind the production of transgenic plants, we have to first understand the property of totipotency. So totipotency is what? It is an ability of a single cell to produce the entire organism. You will be surprised to know that each and every plant cell, whether it is a root cell, whether it is a stem, whether it is epicotyl, hypocotyl, pollen, even ovule or ovary, whatever it is, if we are able to provide appropriate nutrients to the cell and controlled environmental conditions like temperature, humidity, pH, what we can achieve? We can achieve the development of an entire plant body from that single cell. Why? Because each and every cell of a plant is having the property of totipotency naturally. So from a single plant cell, we can generate an entire plant body. This is a very, very beneficial property of plant cells, which helps us to generate genetically modified plants into the laboratory conditions. Let's see how this property helps us. This is the basic scheme of the production of transgenic plants. What we have to do, at first, we are having a population of the desired gene, multiple copies of the gene we are having. What we have to do first, we have to transfer the gene into the plant cell. And for transferring the gene into the plant cell, we can adopt any of the two methods. One method is vector mediated method, and another method is a vectorless or direct gene transfer method. The most important vector which we can use to transfer the foreign gene into the plant cell is Ti plasmid. Ti plasmid is tumor inducing plasmid, and it is found inside the bacterium named as Agrobacterium tumefaciens. It is basically a pathogen of plant cells and it induces tumor inside the cells of the plant. But we can utilize its plasmid, which is named as tumor inducing plasmid, to deliver our gene into the nucleus of the plant cells. If we do not want to take the help of the vector, what we can do, we can directly deliver our gene into the plant cell using one of these three methods. One is electroporation, another one is microinjection, and the third one is gene gun. See, we are not going into details of these methods because they will be dealt in the chapter of plant tissue culture. But for the basic idea, I tell you what electroporation is. Electroporation is the process of creation of pores inside the plant cells using electric field. And through these pores, the DNA can enter into the plant cells. Microinjection is injecting DNA into plant cells using some micro syringe or micro manipulator. And gene gun, it is the method in which we fire gene like bullets towards plant tissue, which is to be transformed using an instrument named as gene gun. So there are two types of methods. One is vector mediated method and another one is non vector mediated or direct gene transfer methods. Either of these two can be adopted to successfully transfer the gene into the plant cell. One thing should be kept in mind that whenever we try to insert our gene into the plant cells, not all plant cells allow the gene to enter inside those cells. So what we have to do, we have to select only those plant cells which have successfully received the desired gene. And such plant cells are known as the transformed plant cells. So now we have selected only what kind of cells? We have selected transformed plant cells. You can see that desired gene has been integrated into the DNA, into the nucleus of the plant cell. What to do next? We transfer these transformed cells into a simple nutritive growth medium. It is such a medium which is having the nutrients so as to facilitate the division of those plant cells. And that event is known as culture in vitro. So the cells will be lying in the medium, they will utilize the nutrients, they will face the optimal environmental conditions inside laboratory, and they will be dividing by mitosis. So what you will get a population of transformed plant cells into that particular medium. So what will be next? Now what you have a suspension of transformed plant cells inside your culture vessel. In that particular medium, what the cells are doing? They are dividing by mitotic cell division. And when a cell divides by mitosis, you know very well that one cell divides and gives rise to two cells, and these two cells are having the same genetic material as that of the parental cell. That's why ultimately all the cells which are present in this particular growth medium, they all will be having the same genetic material, and they all will be having the gene of interest into the DNA, into their nuclei, because they have descended from the mitotic division of the parental cell. And parental cell was transformed plant cells. So this transformed plant cells will divide several times mitotically in the medium, and eventually all the cells lying in that particular medium, they will all be having the same genetic makeup. So they will all be having the gene of interest inside their DNA. So now we are having a population of transformed plant cells. What we do next? We transfer these cells into a special type of medium that is called as the regeneration medium. And this regeneration medium is a kind of medium which is having growth regulators so as to allow each and every cell to give rise to root and shoot and to develop into a complete plantlet. And now remember that each and every cell of a plant is having totipotency. That's why more the number of cells inside your medium, the more number of plantlets you can get from these cells. In fact, each and every plant cell can give rise to an individual plantlet. So this is the benefit of the property of totipotency. So students, again, see carefully what we have done. We have transferred those transformed cells to regeneration medium. That medium is containing growth regulators like auxins, cytokinins, which facilitate the induction of the complete plantlet from the plant cells. And this becomes possible because of the capacity which is exhibited by each and every cell, that is totipotency, and by which each and every plant cell can give rise to a complete plantlet. Auxin, which is present in the medium, it generates roots, and cytokinins generate shoots. So accordingly, if you are having hundreds of cells inside your medium, hundreds of transformed cells are there into your medium, you can generate hundreds of plants, and those all plants will be identical to each other genetically, and they will be clones of each other. So what you will get? You will get a plant variety, you will get a transgenic plant variety, and you will get multiple copies of that variety. So that is the entire scheme of the generation of a transgenic plant. First, you will introduce the gene into the plant cell, then you will select the plant cells which have been transformed, then you will multiply the number of these plant cells by using some nutritive growth medium. Then what you will do, you will transfer those plant cells into another kind of medium which is known as regeneration medium, so as to ensure that each and every plant cell gives rise to a complete plantlet. And at the end, what you get a population of plants which are genetically 100% identical, and all they are having the DNA insert into their genome. So that was the basic scheme of generation of transgenic plants. Let's take an example of transgenic plant which is most popular. It is known as the Bt cotton. Bt cotton is what? It is a resistant transgenic cotton variety which produces an insecticide to combat bollworm, preventing spoilage of cotton. So there is an insect pest named as bollworm, and this causes huge loss to cotton plants. That's why scientists have developed a resistant variety of cotton, and that cotton is known as Bt cotton. So it is basically a resistant transgenic cotton variety. So let's see what happens. There is a bacterium named as Bacillus thuringiensis, and this bacterium contains cryogenes into its genome, and one of these cryogenes is Cry1ac. And what this gene does, this gene codes for a protein named as crystal protein, and this crystal protein has insecticidal capabilities, and it kills bollworm. And bollworm is such a worm that spoils the cotton fields by infecting them. So what scientists thought? They thought of integrating that Cry1ac gene into the genome of the cotton plant, which happens to be sensitive to bollworm, to generate such cotton plants which now became resistant towards the action of the bollworm. And such transgenic plants came to be known as Bt cotton. So what they did, they isolated Cry1ac gene from Bacillus thuringiensis, they cloned the Cry1ac gene, and thereafter they integrated the gene into the genome of the cotton plant so as to generate a transgenic variety which is known as the Bt cotton. Some more examples of transgenic varieties are there. You must have heard about golden rice. It is a rice which is having the improved pro-vitamin A content. Transgenic papaya, and it is known to contain the virus resistance. There is a virus named as papaya ring spot virus which causes profound spoilage to the papaya, but now a transgenic variety has been developed which is having the resistance to the infection of the virus. Genetically modified tobacco has been developed, which has a reduction in the nicotine content. Nicotine is basically an addictive central nervous system stimulator, and which is not good for the human health perspectives, which is not good according to the human health. That's why what scientists did, they inserted a gene into the tobacco to reduce the production of nicotine. Some crops are there which are known as Roundup Ready GM crops, and one of them is canola. And why they are called Roundup Ready? Because they are having herbicide resistance. And the Roundup is basically the trade name of a herbicide which is known as the glyphosate. So such canola, they are ready to face the most usually used herbicide that is known as the glyphosate. That's why such canola is known as the Roundup Ready canola. So golden rice having improved protein A, transgenic papaya having virus resistance, GM tobacco having the reduced nicotine, and Roundup Ready canola is having the resistance towards herbicide. So in some examples, we are seeing that an entirely new character has been developed, like in papaya. But in some examples, we are seeing that the rice was containing provitamin A, but it was not in much quantity in the grain. So that's why we have produced golden rice, so as to improve the provitamin A content. So this example is basically we are improving, we are facilitating some useful trait of the plant. And in that example, what we are doing, we are reducing a non-beneficial trait of the plant. And in that particular example, what we are doing, we are introducing an entirely new character in the plant. So all the examples, they can be categorized into three categories, which I've already discussed: to reduce the phenotypic effect of any gene which is undesirable, to improve the phenotypic effect of a useful gene present in the plant, or to confer an entirely new character to the plant which is it never had before. So these three objectives are there to achieve those we generally generate transgenic plants. So I hope you are getting some basic idea about the production and the objectives of transgenic plants. See this video very carefully. That's all for today's lecture. Thanks for watching. Queries are welcome.